Once we have finished a drawing, it is highly possible that we would like to print it. In this example, an architectural drawing has been created in millimeters. I can print it directly from Model Space if I click on the plot icon in the Quick Access toolbar, or if I expand the File menu and select Plot. Alternatively, I can click on the AutoCAD icon and select the Print option. In this example, I will click on the plot icon in the Quick Access toolbar. Since, apart from the Model tab, there are two extra layout tabs, a message appears asking me if I wish to plot multiple sheets. However, I only wish to plot the drawing that is shown in the model, so I will select the Continue to plot a sheet option. Automatically, the plot model window appears. Firstly, I have to select a printer, so I will expand the drop-down menu, and in this example, I will select the DWG to PDF option. Next, I have to specify the paper size. Since I want to print my drawing in an A4 paper, I will search in the options of the list, and I will select the ISO A4 size. Then, I have to specify which part of the model space will be printed. So, in the plot area, I will expand the list and I will choose the window option. The plot model window disappears automatically to allow me to select the area that will be printed directly from model space. Now, all I have to do is create a rectangular area by specifying its two corner points like I would do if I created a rectangle. So I will click on the upper left corner and then on the lower right corner of the drawing area, making sure that all the views are completely enclosed in the rectangular area. Once I clicked to specify the second point, the plot model window reappeared. From the plot offset options, I will activate the center the plot option so the drawing will be printed in the center of the paper. From the plot options, I will make sure that plot object line weights as well as the plot transparency are selected. If I unselect those two checkboxes, the thickness of the lines and the transparency will be ignored. Then I will also specify the drawing orientation. In the current example, I will select the landscape orientation. Next, I have to specify the scale. For this reason, I will deactivate the Fit to Paper option. Once I do that, the Scale field becomes active, so I will expand the drop-down menu and select the 1 to 100 option. At this point, I will click on the Preview button to see the result before I proceed to print it. As you can see, with this scale set, the drawing doesn't fit to the paper, so I have to either change the paper size or the scale of the drawing. I will close the preview, and in this example, I will change the scale to 1 to 150. However, this option is not available in the list. In this case, I will use the fields under the list to specify the scale manually. I will set the unit's value to 150, so 1 mm on the paper will correspond to 150 drawing units, and click on the preview again to see the result. This time the scale seems fine, so I will close the preview again, and finally I will click OK to print the drawing. Since I am printing the drawing in PDF, I will have to select a folder to save it. I will open the desktop folder and save it with the suggested name. After a few seconds, we can see the result.